We made it through the storm. Now we have to fight another storm. And it's just not fair.
People living on Fort Myers Beach have had their fair share of problems recovering from Hurricane Ian. One guy in particular says he's been forced to live in his garage after his home was destroyed. The town signed off on Rick Loffrey's permits to fix up his garage, and now they're saying it actually needs to be brought up to code or torn down.
Loffrey is so fed up with the process, he's decided to protest on the roof of his garage. Take a look. This is a live look. He has been up there for 2 days now. NBC2's Gage Golding is with Loffrey right now along Estero Boulevard. Gage, so why did the town change its mind about approving the permits in the first place?
So it's a little thing, but it's a big deal. You see this right here. You kind of see the outline of where the roof used to be. This is called the flashing, and that's kind of where the house attached, in air quotes here, to the garage. But you can see the garage on its own, it stands on its own. But this flashing here, well, the town says this is what connects the two structures together and made it one. And that's why they say they need to bring it now. Now, what's the real hiccup here is that the town already approved permits for Rick and his wife, Amy, to go ahead and renovate and repair their garage from Hurricane Ian. But now they're walking back on that and they're saying, we probably shouldn't have done that because they're attached. And, you know, it's kind of frustrating, especially after you spend $25,000. It would drive you up a wall. Well, Rick, it drove him up to the roof. Rick, you're up there right now, and I got to know, I mean, what made you want to go up to the roof in the first place, Rick?
Just to find answers to our problems.
And, I mean, $25,000 to get this garage back up and running, and that's not a small chunk of change, and that's kind of why you're up here right now?
Yeah, that's kind of the reason. You know, we just can't get any solid answers to our architects or engineers who drew the plans up. They just can't find the right answers from the town to say that we can't have it. So that's why I'm up here. So.
And you're quite the spectacle here. I hear a lot of horns honking. It's the community support that's also keeping you rallied up here as well, right?
Well, the community has a lot of issues too, and that's one of the reasons I'm also up here, is because my community is suffering just as bad as I am.
So, and if you can't see the storm clouds behind us, you've been up here through the heat and through the rain and through the weather. What is it going to take to bring you back down here on the ground?
For either my engineers and architects or my permitter to get an answer from either the state or the town as to what code applies to the reason I have to knock down my garage.
Well, Rick, we got a couple of answers from the town of Fort Myers Beach. I'm reading them here because I want to get them correct. The first one, there's three of them. The first one, build a new attached home and bring the garage up to code. That means more money for Rick and Amy. The second is convert the garage to a standalone structure, which Rick and Amy says it already is. The town says it's not. So convert it to a standalone structure and then build a separate home, right? And then the third option is bulldoze it and start from scratch. Now, FEMA was here earlier today. I asked Rick and Amy exactly how that conversation went. They said it was good, but they don't have any answers. And until those answers come, you'll find Rick right up there on the roof. I'm reporting live and local on Fort Myers Beach. Gage Golding, NBC2.